Hello, I'm Bob Cannon, your Clinton Township Supervisor, and with me today is William Wood, who is the man in charge of all the fantastic things that have happened in this auditorium for the last several years. I like coming here not only to see you and what you've done, but because I like Al Lorenzo and what he did for this college and all the foresight he had, and I was so happy and proud when they named this building after him.
Yes, you know, Mr. Lorenzo, or President Lorenzo at the time, was a key factor in why we have what we have here.
Exactly. This is not the first time we've been here with you, and every time we come, we see something new and something that we like and something that we had forgotten about. So tell us what this, whose dream was this? Was this yours or was it a group?
We have a group of people that we call the program team that meet on a regular basis and come up with the different ideas of what our exhibits are going to be into the future. Some of them we're our traveling exhibits that we bring to Macomb County. Others are ones like this one where we're developing it from scratch ourselves. We do all the research internally. We do all the graphics internally. We do everything from the ground up on these exhibits within the staff that we have at Macomb.
Today is mid-March. How long will this exhibit be here for us to enjoy?
It'll be here through the end of April. I believe April 28th or 29th is the last day.
So you basically have another 6 weeks to get over here and take a look at it.
Absolutely.
And what are your hours?
Our hours are Tuesday through Saturday, 10 to 4.
Okay, so that's good. That gives people plenty of time to get here during the day. And I ask you this every single time. There's so much here, you can't possibly walk around and see it all in a very short time period. If you were to tell people to come and see one or two items, what would be the one or two items that you would say you cannot leave here without seeing or touching?
I think because this exhibit is about the mid-century modern period, which is right after World War II and into 1970, was driven a lot by the automotive design. It made Detroit a hub, a catalyst for that whole movement. So what I would recommend for people is to come out and maybe see some of the automotive and some of the architectural displays that we have out here, because those were areas that were being led so strongly by the auto industry and by this region. You know, we also are touching on the music of that era. So we've got a lot of very interesting stuff about music here as well. And then, of course, a lot of the everyday items. I'm not going to go into the whole long list. Everything from children's toys that were affected by that movement on up to chair design, all those kinds of good things as well.
I was privileged to go to Wayne State University starting in 1967. So a lot of what you're talking about here, I saw firsthand, the cast corridor, all the change with companies like Verner's and others that are no longer downtown Detroit. But it's been a thrill to see the automotive industry continue to develop in the Detroit area.
Absolutely. You know, they're a major factor in why this area is so dynamic, arts and culturally, economically, socially, in so many ways. They've really driven so much, pardon the pun, I guess, they've really driven what's happened in this part of the world.
Well, we're proud of Detroit. We're proud of what you've done here at the center, the Lorenzo Center. If you have an opportunity, come out and enjoy. You cannot walk through here in 5 minutes. You can come here and see one or two things in 5 minutes, which if you can't stay longer, come and do it because it's fantastic. So thank you for watching CTTV today. We'll be back the next time he's got something spectacular, which I'm sure it won't be that long down the road, to show us. Thank you.